What's going on, everybody? Crazy Dog back with another video, and this will be my Browns Jaguars week 12 recap, as the Browns win yet another hard fought game by a final score of 27-25, and we improve to 8-3 on the year. And of course, this guarantees the Browns a winning season for the first time since 2007, when they went 10-6 with Romeo Crennel at head coach. And of course, Derek Anderson was the quarterback of that squad. And now look, we're 8-3. We're heading into week 13 next week, going to Tennessee to face off against Derrick Henry, Ryan Tannehill, and the Tennessee Titans, who are also 8-3. And word on the street is they're thinking about flexing this game to Sunday Night Football. And honestly, I'm all for it. The only bad thing about it is I would have to wait the entire day to see my team play. And I freaking hate that. But hey, you know, seeing this squad on Sunday Night Football, that'd be pretty cool. You know, after not seeing them on Sunday Night for over a decade, and then last year, they're finally on Sunday Night Football against the Rams. Of course, they lost. You know, this would mean that it'd be the second straight year that we're on Sunday Night Football. But hey, it'd be one hell of a matchup. You know, 2-8-3 teams facing off. You'd love to see it. Now, looking at this game, I'll be completely honest with you. Heading into this game, I did not expect it to be this close. I thought we were going to blow these guys out. I mean, my final score prediction was 35-10, and we wound up winning by 2 freaking points because, as we saw out there, our defense misses Myles Garrett and Denzel Ward. They really miss those guys. We had virtually no pass rush, and our secondary was getting picked apart by Mike freaking Glennon. Mike Glennon, the same dude who lost his job to Mitchell freaking Trubisky. Like, huh? Bro, I mean, what? God, we're lucky they didn't have DJ Chark or Conley or D.D. Westbrook, or they probably would have tore us up. But even then, you know, they had some success through the air. Most of their damage was done on the ground. As we saw freaking James Robinson, 22 carries, 128 yards, 1 touchdown. On our side, Nick Chubb, 19 carries, 144 yards and a touchdown. Very impressive. Kareem Hunt, 10 carries, 62 yards. He was pretty good. Jarvis Landry had a day. 8 receptions, 143 yards and a touchdown. Not arguably. That was his best game of the year. Now, in terms of Baker Mayfield's performance, 19-29, 258 yards, 2 touchdowns, and he had a rating of 116. He was sacked twice, too, especially on that first play of the drive start. Because for some reason, we decided, you know what, to start off this drive, let's go 5 wide, okay? And then Baker gets sacked on the very first play of our first possession. Tough. But yeah, defense was getting torched all game. Luckily, our offense was pretty much on point. Of course, Baker did miss a wide open Higgins. He missed a wide open Kareem Hunt. Although, they were partially on the receivers a little bit. You know, but that Higgins throw was kind of on Baker the most because he needs to lower that ball. His ball placement still is kind of bad. Although his footwork mechanics is looking pretty good, though. But yeah, Jarvis was out here saving Baker's skin so many times today, man. I freaking love Jarvis. God, man, can't say that enough. Jarvis is clutch as hell, bro. For real. I don't know what we would do without him. Whenever we need a big play, he came up with that big play today. And you love to see it. Now, I already know a lot of Browns fans are going to come out here and rage about the officiating. Now, I'm not one to blame everything on the refs, but today, the officiating was kind of sus, especially late in the game. You know, you had those 2 bad calls with the ball placement. It looked like Kareem Hunt clearly got the first down, not once, but twice. Of course, that was prior to the pass from Baker that Hunt could not bring in. He was wide open, by the way. And then, you know, I think we went for it on 4th down. Didn't get it. So, yeah, that's tough. But then you have the sack by Vernon where they called, I believe it was unnecessary roughness, when I didn't really see anything there. So, yeah, Jerome Boger, your officiating crew was not very good today. I'd give it maybe like a C-, a D+. Right? It wasn't the worst game I've ever seen, but it was up there in terms of officiating. But yeah, I mean, we didn't really help matters because we were derping out there so hard. Baker Mayfield was out here doing his best Jekyll and Hyde impression. Like, this dude would make the hard throws and then miss the easy ones. Like, what's up with that? I said it during my stream. He's literally the Browns version of J.R. Smith. J.R. would miss the open threes and then hit the contested ones. Like, what's up with that? You'd think it'd be the other way around. But hey, he didn't throw any interceptions. Although Harrison Bryant did fumble one time, of course. You know, not a very good day for Harrison. But hopefully he'll get over it and, you know, he'll be ready for next week. You know, don't let it, you know, stick with you. It happens. You know, everyone has a bad game now and then. But hey, Hoover got in the end zone. That was great. You know, Jarvis scored. Hooper scored. Chubb freaking got in the end zone again. You'd love to see it. This offense looked good. But then you look on our defense and they were getting torched. Like I said earlier, they were getting torched by Mike Glennon and James Robinson. Like, what? Oh, my God, bro. For real. We can't do this against Tennessee. Hopefully Miles is back. Denzel, who knows when he'll be back. Ronnie Harrison got hurt on the first play of the game. Hope he's all right. It's a shoulder injury. That's tough to see. But how about Andrew Sendejo? He made a couple good plays. We must be in the twilight zone because the dude usually sucks. But what do you know? Today he made a clutch stop in the end zone, and then he made actually another stop on a two-point attempt that would have tied the game. So there you go. Sendejo came up clutch today. Hope he can keep it up. But, yeah, Browns win. We're 8-3 on to Tennessee. Before I get on out of here, I got to give a quick shout-out to some Jaguars fans. Of course, my guy UCF Jaguar, Jagging Off, and I got Andrew from the Jaguar podcast. I'll put the link to his channel down in the description. I was on his podcast on Friday, so I hope you guys go over there and check that out. You know, show him some love. Tell him Crazy Dog sent you. But, yeah, we're 8-3. And we're right in the thick of things in the playoff picture. Let's just keep winning. We've got Tennessee next week. It's going to be a tough one. But, yeah, man, you know, another victory means another Victory Monday. So I'll see you guys tomorrow for Victory Monday, number 8 on the year. Yeah, 8 on the year. And let's keep this train rolling. But, yeah, that's going to wrap it up. And I'm CrazyDog99. As always, shout out to my Dog Pound brothers. And like I said, man, let's keep this train rolling. Keep winning. Winning's fun. This is the most wins I've experienced as a YouTuber. Isn't that crazy? You know, this is fun. I love this. Let's keep it going. This is addicting, you know. But man, dude, let's freaking go. Yeah, I'm Crazy Dog. Let's go, Browns. And I'm out.